Representing the third game in the series, Monkey Island is a series published by LucasArts that was released for the PC in 1997. This game is a point-and-click adventure game in which the player will control an X-shaped cursor rather than the character themselves, and use it to select items to interact with, lines to speak, or mechanisms to operate. This game features interesting logic puzzles and very humorous lines that are highlighted thanks to being the first of the series to include voiceover actors.
I've never seen such clumsy swordplay.
Coupled along with very impressive cinematics, it's no wonder this game holds up to its great ratings from top critics. The music was taken care of by Michael Land, who first came on with LucasArts in 1990 for the first game of the Monkey Island series. His work there led to the co-developing of the system LucasArts would use for many games until about the early 2000s called iMuse, a program which would allow music to be dynamically changed based on what's happening in the game seamlessly. The soundtrack contains a mixture of Caribbean-based song styles, piratey, swashbuckling jig music, and some tribal-sounding mysterious music. Thank you so much, Mr. Land, for this awesome soundtrack. We will be covering a track called Mocking the Voodoo Lady and Voodoo Jazz in today's episode of Stick to Games. Hey everybody, Kenny Jr. here, and welcome back to Stick to Games. Today's lesson is going to be all about reggae. Reggae is a popular form of music that hails from the Caribbean. It was developed in around the 1960s. The most recognizable reggae artist might be Bob Marley. Reggae is a style of music that musically tends to be really chill. Rhythmically speaking, reggae is usually like kind of half swung, slightly shuffled, and the most notable pattern on drums is called the one drop. So if you're ready to explore this style of music, let's take it to the set. So in our track today, Mocking the Voodoo Lady, we're gonna start off with a cool intro that's in 6-4. It's gonna involve the use of drags, sextuplets, and some crazy notated 32nd notes. Once we've done our introduction, we're going to get into the first measure of the pattern. We put it back in 4-4, and you'll notice that we're performing a cross stick as well as our kick all on the 3. This is the notation of the 1 drop, where the 3 gets the emphasis and all the other beats remain empty. The reason for this is to leave a lot of room for other rhythmic ideas from the instruments or the vocalist. Plus, it naturally gives off that easygoing vibe associated with the genre. And that's pretty much all there is to the reggae one drop pattern. Now I'm also going to show you a couple of common improvised patterns that you'll hear with the cross stick snare drum. These can be observed in measures 5 and 13 in our music. And again, even these patterns leave a lot of room for other rhythmic ideas from our other members of the ensemble. In this particular part, I'm also going to show you a couple of other fills that they have towards the end here. Now in reggae, there is something also known as a stepper's pattern. This is gonna be played with the kick drum doing a 4 to the floor. That is, every quarter note will be hearing the kick drum. Snare will still be going on the 3 and your little variations as well. And that just about does it for this particular track. Not much more to say about it, so let's go ahead and run it top down. And alright everybody, that just about covers everything we had to talk about today. If you enjoyed this video, please remember to hit that like button, and also subscribe so you can see my future videos. Remember to hit me up on social media, Instagram or Twitter, if you want to make a special request for a video, or if you just want to drop by and say hi. Also, be sure to check out my website, where you can find these transcriptions as well as other content that I produce. I hope you enjoyed everything today, and I hope to see you again soon. Till next time.